Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dot DJ Productions. And tonight I'm going to be driving Ricardo Diaz over the castle as well, on a bit of a sort of casual run, I suppose. So we're going to be going from here, we're going to Holmesley from Broadstone down here. So, yeah, I don't know what I'm going to be talking about. I've got Chris here. I'm hoping to get some other peeps in a little bit later, perhaps. But but for now, we've just got, unfortunately, we just have Chris.
Oh, fuck you.
And very unfortunately, we just have Chris. And I know what a disappointment that is to everybody. So,
I love you guys, too.
No, you don't. Anyway, I suppose I better turn up TS sounds ever so slightly, because all my other sounds are down.
Yes, and so is your fan.
Yeah, you can hear the fan in the background, can you?
Yeah, it's not too annoying. Good. People, it's hot.
It is really hot, by the way, if anyone's wondering.
So live with it.
Or don't. It's up to you, I guess. Fair enough. It's up to you. I like how I just heard myself. It was funny. Anywho, should we get this journey rocking and rolling, I suppose?
Do it.
Now, what I'm going to say as well is that I'm going to be doing a video tomorrow, everybody, on the new Britannic game that's come out. Well, I say game, it's more like the Britannic experience on Steam. So I'm really looking forward to showing you guys that, because I absolutely love the Britannic. So I'll be making a proper feature-length video on that tomorrow, possibly. But unfortunately for now, you're going to have to settle with Rick. Because I know people have been asking why I haven't driven Rick very much, and not that I don't drive him, it's just, I don't know, I don't drive him very often. Well, I do drive him, to be fair, but I just sort of don't drive him in context of whatever's going on.
What I was asking you something, Tom.
Yeah?
Have you heard the word?
Oh,
you know,
mate,
the word.
Oh, yeah, I know about the word. Everybody knows about the word.
You sure?
I'm pretty sure that everyone knows about the word.
Because if it's the word I'm thinking of.
Is it the word?
I think it's the word I'm thinking about as well.
Is it...
The word.
Oh my god, I can't believe that. That's great.
Oh, we're such fucking nerds.
That would be a really nice screen grab there. With all the shadows and everything.
Aloha Gwell just puts bird in the chat 3 times. So, let's just go into the chat and bang Guam for spamming. I'm joking.
I wouldn't do that. That's a bit mean.
Yeah. And David Seward says, have you heard the bird is the word?
No. Oh my god, my rake is destroyed. Look, I've got a chocolate and cream RMB.
My OCD wants to murder you.
Yeah, but it's only that one coach. Leave me alone.
Yeah, it's pissing me off.
Good.
If it was a mixture of a button. If it was a mixture of a bunch of coaches, it would have been fine, but since it's just the one...
You don't have to look at it, it's fine.
Hang on. Someone just said, I'm late. Someone in chat gave me a recap. He legit started three minutes ago.
Okay, literally, we just started, so... Here's your recap. We said
bird is the word.
Oh, we're driving Ricardo Diaz. As is evident by his nameplate, if I can get to it.
Were you just waiting for Chris's live stream to end to do this?
Pretty much. See, it says Rick.
It's missing a P.
The silent P at the beginning, yeah?
Yeah, prick.
Aha, yes, there is a reason if someone wonders why I've got 100% reg, reverse even, there is a reason. I need to make some steam disappear.
Oh yeah, Tom hates it when Rick blows off.
Yep, I literally hate him for that. It's fine when I need the power, but when I'm just coasting along the press line, dude.
Oh, David's asking if the Dark Railway Members Edition has AWS.
Yes. It also has colour light signals, it's got TPWS, it's got GSRM, all of that jazz.
I think Guion's drunk, because he's asking what your favourite Japanese Steam logo is.
I think I know what he's getting at, and I'm not gonna fall for his bait, because he's just being a prick. Although if Guion did want to join us up in the chat, he's more than welcome to, if he can answer the fabled question. Can Zeke Dark have one of his custard creams?
He just wrote GWR is better than capital no.
Oh. It moved really in it?
Mm-hmm. Also, someone's asking, what DLC are you looking forward to right now?
What am I looking for? What?
What new DLC are you looking forward to right now?
Probably just anything Riftmaker, really, because he's the only he's what I would call an active developer. Because he actually, you know, develops stuff quickly and releases them. I don't know what everyone else's release schedule is, to be quite honest. I mean,
there is none.
Well, the 28th is allegedly coming soon, but I've already driven that, and I'm hoping everyone's going to look forward to that when it comes out.
Well, I'm going to be driving the 2800 all day
and
every day.
Oh, Gradient. Oh, look at that. Rick does not like that at all, does he?
Oh, Guyan's pulling controversy in chat.
Why?
He's like, but Tom, it can be driven by a 3-year-old.
So?
So, it's still, I don't know, what's it called? Fun?
I mean, I enjoy driving Rick. He can be driven by a 3-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
So, I must be a
3-year-old. As evident by the fact that I've driven him.
Well, yeah. Well, you're actually 2, Chris, so it's even bigger achievement for you to have done it.
Whoa.
What?
Chris, someone says...
How many people did you kill today?
No, someone's saying, Tom, have you ever thought about doing a prequel series before the 1960s?
No. Yes, I have, really, to be honest. I have thought about
and
it.
We have been joined by the Dacia Sander... I mean, Anthony Banderas.
Oh, I didn't know Anthony was a Dacia Sandera. Come again?
What?
He's the 3-year-olds here.
Yes.
Are we really doing this, honestly, guys, really?
No, we're not.
I don't want anything to do with that.
Let Gwen have his fun.
I just want to casually drive my choo-choo train on the line.
Yeah. Well, I will say this, because Matt Kundrick asked if Cheapside will appear in the prequel. Well, if you look at the wiki, you basically have the prequel there, and that's most likely what the stories are going to be based around,
if I'm not wrong. Shall I literally just make a series called The Story of Cheapside?
Yes.
And just have, like, everybody casting him off for, like, a smaller and smaller amount every time? Until eventually someone actually has to, you know, they actually have to give the dude money in order to take away Cheapside.
Why, they're selling him on the Cheapside?
Again, yes. Although, in fairness, I do like my my big loco that a 3-year-old can drive. Just to point out, I do love my loco. Look at him; he's chonk. He's literally the definition of chonky.
Huh?
Did you literally hear anything I just said?
No, you kind of lied out for me.
Oh, I said that Rick is chunky and he's like my big favourite Chuff Chuff. Wouldn't you agree?
Well, yes, I will agree.
Agui on.
Yeah. Oh, someone just asked, hey Tom, I don't have the platforms for Horton Heath on this route. Do you know what pack I'll need for them to work?
For Horton Heath? I have no idea. I would just say, like, you know, but I'm not tech support, so ask Theme Stand Supreme, I suppose.
Or read the manual. Or look at the website, because they do show off what you need and what you don't need. I believe I can...
Such a chunky boy. Look at him. He's going to eat you for dinner. Anyway, let's leave.
No.
Rick, blow your whistle. Honk. What?
Just imagine if this thing actually visited a real preserved line. It would just basically crush everything.
Hmm.
Oh, mate.
So, I think that...
Sorry, Anthony, go on.
As in they I think that visit from Rick, it was a big success. Sir, you might want to come and have a look at the track.
What's wrong with it? It's straight.
I don't think we have rails anymore.
We've just got ballast. I love these low-speed shafts of Rick when he's not blowing off.
Well, said Pat.
Well, said Pat. Well.
Then who bombed the chairman?
It was John.
Then who bombed Guion?
Me? What? Rick the Destroyer of Worlds. Apparently someone took a lovely picture of Rick on their phone. Hmm. Okay, cool. That's it. If he's in effect, well, Rick, it's Richie Osborne. Don't suppose he's a member of the group, is he? Or just post it to the Facebook page, perhaps. I'm just wondering if he was a member of the group, that's all. The idea is that Rick could possibly visit here one day. That's why I'm running him here anyway.
But would it be structurally sound enough?
No. I do love the dive under though, like so much, like the way that the railway line has to dive underneath the bridge. Even though you can see them clearly enough clearance, I just love the idea of having to clear that bridge.
Ooh.
This route would be preserved in real life. What?
Britain never had two 10-2s though. The only two A2 were the P2s and P1s.
No.
Yes.
You have also the 7200s.
Yeah.
And if we want to go, smaller, we had River Esk and River Mite.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Same as Rick's, based on the two mountain types at the Romney Hive and Dymchurch. Sort of.
Someone also asked, because my IRL friend is in the chat, are you guys looking forward to seeing each other's of your friends again when the virus is over?
I mean, we don't see each other in real life anyway, so
yeah.
I don't have any friends.
Okay, thanks, Tom.
In real life.
Thanks, Tom.
I have enemies. Go on, say it again, Chris.
I mean, hi, Tom.
I wonder how many people out there are actually looking forward to Rick's introduction to TDRS, you know?
Well, funny that you just got a thing about it.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, someone said, I hope season 10 takes place in the late 70s. I'm dying to see Rick's completion and the visual adaptation of the original 1202.
Oh yeah, well that's not happening quite yet because we've still got 1976, the rest of 1976, and then 77, 78, and 89, 79 even before we get to that point.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry, we've got an action plan. Kind of. I'm tweaking it. Today.
Action man.
Action man is an action plan.
I'm a foreigner, what do you expect? Sam, fuck off, you're not a foreigner, you're a Dane.
I didn't count Seb as foreign. I mean, I count him as my worst abbreviation enemy.
Yeah.
Seb is my lovely little abbreviation enemy because we both share the same anagram. Abbreviation, even.
I just need to point this out. To Corey, where's Tales from the New West Section is Andy dead? Andy's not dead. He's getting there.
That
lockdown stuff.
That's kind of a little bit of a tactless question, especially during this coronavirus outbreak.
Yeah, people have their stuff.
Andy is basically he's trying to get himself sorted out because he's been isolated throughout this whole thing. Hasn't been able to see his family. He's now seeing his family and his girlfriend. So, just basically, all I'm going to say about Andy is leave him alone for the time being and let him just be him for a bit.
Yeah, and what I will also say is, and Andy's server the other night, he did say, I'm actually getting back into my interest of working on projects. We'll see. I'm about to try and start working on episode 2 or part 2.
Right.
So, give him time. It's the same reason why I haven't done RTR episode 3. Not the time to do such things. It's not Tom can attest to this. It's not just a simple thing of 1, 2, 3 and you're ready.
It's not easy being green when you're covered in blood.
Thanks. Did you overshoot, Tom?
No. Had to go this far forward to clear the loop.
Did you undershoot?
No. But oh, I am gonna trigger you, by the way.
Oh, for fuck's sake. What have you done?
Woo!
Oh, you prick.
It's a buffet car! It's a buffet car! And it's the wrong colour for this contest. Woo!
What's the longest whistle you have on Rick? Probably the spacebar one, because he can just hold it to infinity.
It's probably something like that. Or... I do love Rick's whistle. I know it's literally just a steamboat whistle, but it suits him so much more than the Cardian that it came from. Oh, Rick!
What's he done?
Look what he's doing! Rick, you're not messing with him off at a station, you pillock! I'm gonna start calling you Rick the Prick. I'm gonna start touching you up. Inappropriately, you stupid big steam engine.
David Romaine, you have missed nothing.
That's one way to burst out some pressure.
Fuck off, David, god damn it.
What?
He was like, everyone in chat, you've been rickrolled.
Pretty much. Yeah, what do we think? Whistle suits him, ladies and gents?
No. I think your name's Tom.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't think that was true. I thought that was a cock-picking lie.
Oi. Sounds like a bagpipe.
You sound like a bagpipe.
Well, you sound like a grenade.
I love it when they're whistle playing harmony together.
True.
Because there's a whistle that sort of like goes low high and then it goes high low afterwards. Like that.
Chuffa.
Can you imagine being on a brake van ride up, like this view?
Yes.
but stupidly long heavy freight train.
Hmm?
Happy kid.
You know what you should do, Tom? You should give Rick the RSC7F whistle.
No.
That's been suggested by one of the people in the chat.
Right, no! What is wrong with you people?
Everything. Nah, a diesel horn. Oh my god.
Man, what is wrong with peeps? Gotta look out, don't you, work camera views? Oh, by the way, everyone, I asked Chris Wilson, right, as in the builder of the locomotive, what that is there, right? And he doesn't even know what that is. Anybody got any suggestions? Because I only think I know what that's supposed to represent.
That's a component.
Thank you, Chris, for that that advertisement, that observation.
Someone said it's a gun.
Yeah, clearly, it's Rick's machine gun.
And the time bomb.
I think machine guns are probably easier to... Well, no, I thought machine guns were there.
Yeah.
Those are machine guns.
They're slightly angled, though.
Yeah, but that's so they can hit you in the leg.
Right. Okay, now, two people have asked questions, right?
Uh-huh, go on.
Now, one of them is, I would like to ask if if Rick is going to be a bad character like Leanne or a good character like Dave. Well, good.
Well, you know, Rick is going to be like, you know, the railway's flagship locomotive when he's built, so he's got to be... He's going to be very... young and curious and probably slightly hyperactive by the magic as well, and very sort of, you know,
questioning everything.
Yeah, he questions a lot. He's very curious, a bit like Abomination really, but he's not as intelligent as Abomination.
Yeah, and the second,
you got to remember that Abomination sat in Hunslet Works for 4 years reading books. Rick has just literally come out and been told, right, you're a steam train, you're going to work, and he's like, oh,
chuff.
Yeah, he's literally just like chuff.
And second thing is, have you ever tried pushing Rick to his limits?
Yes. It doesn't go well. I remember trying to get him to go around a corner at like 99 miles an hour, and it was just like, nope, nothing yet.
No, but yeah. And now we arrive at a Tom place that Tom likes a lot.
Do you remember the name of the station, Chris? No.
Ashley Heath? No,
that's the next station.
Craft.
Westmoors.
Westmoors, that's the one. I'm horrible at station names.
Completely remodeled to look like Groombridge on the set of Far Valley. So this is probably one of my favourite sounds on the whole logo.
Oh.
I don't know if you can hear it. I'll turn the sounds up briefly. I'm going to turn the sound up briefly so you guys can hear it.
Oh, that's such a nice sound.
I know, I love it.
Someone also said, you got Rick to 90 miles an hour? Yes, yes, you did.
I can get Rick to about 90, yeah.
And the other thing was, I meant like haulage. What's the max he could pull in terms of freight?
Oh, do you know what? His simulation is a little bit out of whack, because he can haul what he's designed to haul up certain banks, but sometimes he just can't make it. Really depends, because like I tried to take something like 30 war wells over the port road, and I couldn't get out of the hill after I couldn't get up the hill with all of them after I think I'm coming up to what's that hill after Maxwell Town?
Lockenhead? No, that's not it.
Not Cagunzan either. But it doesn't matter. I stalled with 30 flatbed wagons full of army stuff on the one in Sigdip, I think it was.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm going to turn the sound back down. We've had enough of listening to Rick's thing. Air pump.
I have just become the most extremely happy.
Why?
I can see rain clouds on the horizon.
Oh, thank God for that. Well, I wish I had some. I'm literally melting like a big fat melting melt. What the hell are you doing, Ricky? Are you moving?
Someone just asked as well, this is directed at me, are you the voice actor for Mr. B, Chris? Because I like the funny crappy moments with Mr. B and the trucks from Soma, and actually, yeah, I am. Tom forced me. It was against my will.
Did not force you.
I am the Norwegian voice actor who screamed.
I've got to turn the sound back up again.
Oh, we gotta hear this.
Mate, you sound so powerful.
I just had a Krauser incident.
I know essentially it's just like recycled sound from other engines, but I really don't care.
Yeah.
Like combined with everything.
Yeah, I get you, man.
It's just a very funky, unique look. Chuff chuff.
Yes. It's actually an interesting question I wish we had gotten in the Q&A.
What's that?
When and why did you settle on the green livery for the DR?
I think it's because what was happening was is that when I was trying to think of an actual livery for the DR, my first livery for the DR was purple. Hence why the old livery in purple. And that was done on a old MFTF model of a Jubilee. I've got a picture of it somewhere in my archive. But I chose green because I was basically trying to bring in the Black Fives into the experimental British Railways Apple Green when I was learning to reskin. And I think it's more that I sort of like, originally I had someone else do a reskin for me and I just wanted green with black and white lining, just generic, but when I came back to doing it myself, when I learned how to reskin, I decided to go for the kind of LNER experimental like green that was done in British Railways, except slightly darker. Slightly darker, and obviously, and with Gill Sands and Dark Railway in the brush script, and with the red line along the running plate and on the cylinder covers. Basically, Rick's livery is an exact copy of Dave's livery, because I'm hoping to fade Dave into. He's still going to wear DR green, especially when he's around Rick, but I do want to see him painted in other colours one day, just because I like the fact that Dave has such a big wardrobe, if you like.
Same as
Rick will wear other liveries other than just lined DR green. Like, you know,
he'll wear the black one.
He'll be wearing DR black and DR unlined green as well at some point.
And the weathered variants, like.
Well, yeah, because the idea is that I'm going to have Rick sort of painted green like this after he's been out of his work grey. Or he might even go work grey to unlined green and then be lined out later. But when he's in his lined green livery, he starts to get a bit mucky. So we see him weathered a little bit. Like the lightly weathered version, and then eventually he's heavily weathered and he needs a, like, really needs a bath, and it's just sort of like, you know, Rick's first time ever having a proper, like, you know, clean
up,
you know, and we're basically experiencing the life of a steam engine from an engine that is like completely brand new and doesn't really you know, like, he's a bit scared at first of coming out of the works because he's a bit like, you know, I don't know what I am, I don't understand. Because I think I explained during the Q&A the way that it works, which is that he is preloaded with the English language and understanding, but he acts more like sort of like a curious, sort of like, you know, I'd say sort of like, you know, in a human life, a steam engine in my universe sort of wakes up in a state of sort of like basic awareness. So, I don't know, say like an 8 to a 12 year old, I guess, of a human.
Yeah.
Just because I don't know how I would actually write a story of an engine being a child, especially not being funny. I think it would be really dumb to write a story about Rick, which is like the biggest single unit steam engine in the country, being a baby when he first comes out. It's like, you're not a baby, mate.
True.
This is my station, Chris, Ashley Heath.
Yeah, true. Oh, and by the way...
By the way...
Since we haven't... Oh, that was a lightning flash. We might hear thunder. Ooh. Anyways, that's what I was going to say.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't said it yet
mm-hmm.
on stream, so
mm-hmm.
I think it's about time we finally say it.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to be voicing Rick, and Thomas allowed me to voice Rick. No, I'm joking. Thomas
not.
Voicing Rick.
No,
Thomas
I,
voicing
I have
Rick.
To voice, I literally, unfortunately, it is... I think everyone can probably understand why I have to voice Rick. I have no choice but to voice Rick, because
yeah.
he is basically... Well, for one thing, he's my babby. And secondly, I never intend to write him out of the series, so he'll always be
yeah.
the DR engine, no matter what, obviously, because he's built for that freaking railway.
And the thunder has arrived.
I think it's about time I put some coal in the firebox, finally. I'm trying to let his pressure run down, and now he's got nothing in his firebox. So what do people out there think of the cab, anyway?
It's a cab.
I think my favourite part of the cab, actually, funnily enough, is probably the wood flooring. Wood flooring. I also quite like the pull-down lever for the whistle. That's pretty cool and different. That makes them a bit more unique, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Cab's nice. Very Oregon oranges. I think that was organised. Cab's nice. Good cab.
I still don't know what that handle meant to be. I'm sure that's meant to be the air ejector.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't have a function. It's animated, though, so that's a bonus.
Oh, someone's picked up on what you're doing with L-Trip.
Someone's done what?
Picked up on what you're doing with Trip.
What, bringing him here, you mean?
No, saying like, well, you just spoiled that.
Well, he's going to come
here. I mean, like, someone's saying, like, you made him the black sheep of TDRS.
Yeah, thing is that I introduced Trip. My problem is I was kind of on the hope that somebody else was going to make an N15 at a later point, because I don't like the RSC one, and the Steam Moco Collection one is okay, but the sounds and the textures aren't great. So I've done the best I can with him, but I think the reason he's actually treated like a black sheep is because he's sort of like, you know, he had a really bad impression when he first started on the railway. As
yeah.
in, like, he literally ruined his first impression. Because even 257
yeah.
knew that there were going to be problems there. And I think the thing is that he's, you know, he doesn't really fit in with the fleet, even though he's a southern engine, basically implying the fact that the railway has to have a special, you know, you have to be a special kind of engine to work on a DR, really.
Yeah, you can't just be any Donny, you know, you have to actually...
Not offend everybody, for one thing.
Yeah, not be a prick, like Rick.
Funny. I do love the big chuff-chuff, though.
Oh, man, it's raining so... There's so much rain.
Chris is happy. I'm still warm.
I'm very happy. I might just go outside and take a shower in the rain real quick.
Well, I think you should go outside again.
Ha. 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 The features in Rick Cab is from all regions. DWR, SR, LMS, and LNR, I think, someone said.
Yeah, basically. He's got a big amalgamation of a load of things in a cab.
Yeah.
Because you've got, like, a lever-star reverser, because it's obviously a freight engine, which I think is kind of a bit custom, because you know, which it is. The firebox is a great weapon. Firebox doors, even. I don't really, still not really sure what the reverser was meant to be. Maybe elemental practice. Yeah, the reg, sorry. Shark dress. the bucket is clearly Southern Railway because, you know, we had the.
You kicked the bucket?
Well, yeah.
Does Rick have padded seats? He does.
Yes, he does have padded seats. We want maximum comfort for our drivers and firemen. Oh, that's the other thing. The cab, the way the cab is inspired by Ivatt locomotives, like as in Henry Ivatt, not George Ivatt. You know,
yeah.
Because if you look at Rick's cab, it's very flat and square.
True.
You've got inspiration really from everywhere.
That's the charm of him. He took the best. Well, I say the best. We took stuff from all regions.
Basically, when Chris built Rick, he took features from lots of other engines, basically.
Yeah.
So, you know, he's a massive amalgamation. I mean, clearly, he's got a lot of features. Like, for example, I say that he's weird in a way because he's got like a BR-style front end frames.
Yeah.
Southern Tender. LMS sort of smoke box, maybe. But he's got an LNER-style superheater header. Great Western, I'd say maybe a Great Western-style, what?
Sorry, lightning right outside my window.
Oh, and then obviously the Southern-style tender.
I hope you guys can hear the thunder.
Oh, and Southern as well, the LeMaitre exhaust.
Yeah.
Because he has a LeMaitre exhaust as well, hence the massive chimney. Oh, I can hear the fuzz on your end, Chris. That's great. That's magical. Oh, and the whistle valve is basically pure American because Chris didn't know where to put the whistle valve animation. I'd have said sort of in the middle there, maybe, but yeah. I like the push.
Yeah,
I like the pull down anyway. It's different.
It adds a charm to it, you know?
Yeah, well, the whole loco has a weird charm. I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, and I know he's never going to be like, you know, the most famous of steam engine, but I think that's kind of a shame because I've always seen Rick as being a rolling ambassador to what Chris can do if he puts his mind to it.
I was about to say, it's if you look at this engine, this is literally what Chris can do. He had a shitty MS paint thing that Tom made and a beautiful piece of artwork from Anthony.
I was going to say, you're going to suck off Anthony because you two are like, hey, for each other all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically, Rick's invention was basically, I drew a really crappy drawing of a 480.
With cock and balls.
With cock and balls on the side, which was the Pennington valve gear, which obviously we've now been, you know, tactfully rebranded as Penniston valve gear, not Peniston.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a joke from back in the, that was a really old joke from back in the day. But basically, from that drawing, because I had the concept of it being rebuilt with normal valve gear and everything. And then Anthony came along and he drew, because he said to me, where was it built? And I was like, oh, Bay of Peacock. That was just a random thought in my head. And then Anthony drew his interpretation of Rick, of DR1202, which importantly was labeled. That's literally the only reason he got his number, because the original drawing was labeled DR1202. I had loads of other drawings.
Yeah.
I had drawings of like DR707, which was an engine with electronically operated valve gear. Like
electronically?
Yeah, computerized valve gear.
Mad.
And I think there was also something called Mech Monster, which was like an O102 tank. I basically just like to draw loads of different steam engines, random wacky designs.
Yeah.
But Big Bob, as in DR102, would probably the. You know, and then Anthony drew a picture, and I'm just like, oh my god, I need to write a backstory for this bastard.
Oh shit.
And then a backstory arrived, and then we talked about it for years, about getting one done. I think I asked a certain Mr. James Horrocks once about building Rick.
Yeah.
Glad Chris built him.
Okay, so two things.
Mm-hmm.
Corey Corbett is close to me, and I'm scared. He said, Chris, I'm in Oslo and it's bad where I am. And I'm like, that's like 30 minutes from where I live. Oh God. A second thing is, if the original DR122 had the same front end. Oh, Jesus, Tom.
Yeah, good job that he's had a patch put on him so he doesn't derail on no corners.
Yeah.
Anyway,
as I was saying.
Yeah, as you were saying.
If the, If the original DR122 had the same front end, would that mean that TDRS in TDRS, BR took inspiration from the DR?
Yes. Because the original, literally, if you look at Rick compared to DR1202, as in Big Bob, the original, the main difference is in the cab. Literally, the rest of Rick is more or less, like, aesthetically speaking, the same as the original DR1202, except for the cab window. The original DR1202 doesn't have the cab window that Rick has, because it was a design choice during the reconstruction to make life a bit easier for the footplate crew because of how massive the side sheets were. He also has roller bearings as well. And I think I mentioned it before, he's got an autojector like Abomination. So we basically stole their technology and put it in Rick from Hunslet. So we're nice, aren't we?
Yeah.
Do I have to explain what the autojector does again?
No, the autojector is basically an automatic ejector.
Basically. It's just shortened to autojector because it sounds better. It's also based, based on the Soviet stuff as well. I don't know if you remember, Chris. The whole experimentation with keeping a dog's head alive using a pump of blood.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's where the name autojector comes from, because that's what they called it. They called it the body autojector. So I just called my autojector autojector. But that's what Vic has. So basically, he has a float valve in his boiler. And what happens is once that gets to a certain level, Rick can activate a injector himself if his crew is otherwise preoccupied. So you can leave Rick sat in a siding in steam, leaving cab, and he can safely make sure that he's got... The only problem with that is that he needs to have a full tank of water in the tank, in his tender.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, if he's got no water, he can't inject. But the concept is there. What else is different about it? 275 PSI boiler. God, jeez, what else is different on Rick to the original? That's about it, really. The rest of them pretty much identical.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Incoming thunder.
My helpful took the brakes off, wouldn't it?
You know, Tom, I'm not going to tell you how to run your engines.
But. See more butts?
Yes.
I see Wiener. Any more questions about Rick while we're driving him? Oh my god, someone put a double chimney on Rick. Oh my god. Can you imagine that? Oh mate, I'll tell you what, easy eject on Rick. How hench would that be? You might also notice that even though we've got an Amato exhaust, we're refusing to put smoke deflectors on him.
Yes, put smoke deflectors on him. The Scotsman style.
No.
Do it.
No.
Give it.
I absolutely fucking refuse. I love Rick the way he... I don't like smoke deflectors at the best of times. I can just about tolerate them on Nucleus.
Hey, my ears aren't that big.
What should I say?
That your ears...
Do you think I'm weird for liking driving Rick quite slowly like this?
No. Ladies and gentlemen, let me explain something to you guys. Back in 2016...
You died.
Yes.
On the inside.
Back in 2016, when me and Tom and all the stuff started racing, we were like, oh, this engine isn't fast enough. Like, that was all we cared about. Oh, it doesn't go that fast. It's not useful for races. Nowadays, we're like, how slowly can we get this thing to just plod along?
Yeah, I mean, look at what we did with Denmark with the 2800. I've literally, even though, like, you know, a lot of the internet doesn't seem to realize that video exists, looking at a certain group of people,
mm-hmm.
With that video, I literally had something like, what was it? I think I had 57 loaded coal wagons with the 28, and that was just about its limit to be able to climb Stainmore without stopping at low speed. And it just sounded and it felt great to be able to get such a load up a hill. You know,
that's
what I mean?
Why I had so much fun with the ROD, like the 04.
Yeah.
Because I take the GWR 3000 class because I prefer GWR. That design.
Mm.
But, like, seriously, just getting it... Oh, sorry, guys. Chris's keyboard is loud. Sorry, I forgot to put the noise suppression back on. But, yeah, Just the noise it makes as you just plod along and barely get up a hill.
Yeah, that's what I like. This is why we've got the Heavy Freight Initiative coming to the DR. You know what that means?
Yes.
More heavy freight engines, yay! Let's get rid of everything else. Well, not all but...
Someone just asked a question.
Did they ask a question?
But I can answer it for you.
Can you?
Someone just asked, what software do you use to edit and record?
Premiere.
And I know the answer to this.
Yeah.
Well, no,
oh,
you don't record with Premiere.
No, I record with OBS now.
You record with OBS and you edit with Premiere.
Mm-hmm. And the only reason I don't, because I mean, I feel really dumb really, because when I first got the computer, me and Will sorted it out so that I had a Bandicam license. And it's like, well, every time I was using Bandicam, it was crashing the game. OBS doesn't do that. It's like, oh.
Yeah.
Also, am I the only person who really likes watch? Like, you know, I don't know if anyone's really noticed, but I'm driving Rick in reverse. I must be one of the only people who enjoy running engines at 10 to 1st.
Hmm.
I'm not quite sure why. I think because I can look at them from a 3/4 aspect like this, but still see where I'm going. Also, I think it's probably most appealing angle. Especially on this side, because I just find in driver's side, which is the left-hand side of the loco, it's just got the reverser. But this side's got the ACFI water heater and the air pump and all the other pipe work, so it looks a bit more busy. I'm so glad he put that on there, because he wasn't originally going to put this on there. He was just going to have it boring and plain, but I really love all this equipment on the side. It gives him a more experimental feel.
Yeah.
A bit like Abomination. So he's literally like Abomination's younger brother, but he like built like a shit brick house. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Could you just imagine that? Just like Abomination's like, I'm really powerful and well, and then Rick's just like, dude, I'm probably like 3 times more powerful than you, dude. Relax, dude, we're fine. I'm surprised nobody's done a David Moore yet, and after we go mainline.
We just asked it, Tom, so you have to answer your own question now. Is Rick going?
Well, if we can find a route that will allow him his loading gauge to do it, then yeah. I think he could go mainline, but he'd be limited to about 45 or maybe maximum 60. I think more realistically he'd be limited to about 50 or 60. Because
yeah.
Let's face it, those 5'7" driving wheels do get up to a bit of speed.
So someone just asked, who was the youngest engine before on the DR before Rick? Abomination?
He would build
one of the diesels.
Abomination would build 64. Anyone younger than that, Anthony?
Nope. Abomination is the youngest. Like, the youngest engines aside from that are Warrior and Andy, and they're a year older.
Yeah. Because they were built in 63. So when the events of the DR were going on, like in Season 1, in Universe 77A, Andy and Warrior wouldn't have existed, neither would Abomination. That's so weird to think. In fact, I think in that universe, Abomination probably wouldn't have existed at all.
Wait, so hang on. That means a lot of engines don't exist
in 77A.
In my universe. No, well...
In 77A, a lot of locos probably don't exist in that universe. I know for a fact that Dave Brown and Raymond and Fear and Otto were obviously presumed lost from that universe, so I've no idea what happened to that universe afterwards. They must have just, like, brought some more engines, I guess.
True. Unless... Ooh, actually, Tom. Unless the engines from 77C cross into A. No, that'd be weird.
That would be a bit weird.
Well, no, that would make sense, because that would make sense for why there isn't a Dave, Brian, and Raymond extra in C.
Yeah.
So they'd be like, oh, you remember when
Dave
was
it? Well, basically, yeah, because basically I think what would have happened is when they came back to 77C, they replace what was the engines that were already there.
Yeah, and someone else replaces them in 77A.
Yeah, in 77... No, I think in 77A they're just gone. Huh.
77A is the alt confirmed. Tom was not thinking straight.
No, I'm thinking to get you to shush.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay, bye! Vic is actually Anthony, confirmed.
I mean, it's big enough.
I mean, important question really would be, who would win in a haulage test? Would it be Barry or Rick?
Well, we'll find out one day, won't we? Someone just said... Does this mean the engines in the RTR are in the TDRS universe?
Technically speaking. Right. Okay, so within the 77C universe, which, you know, hasn't really got anything super duper confirmed, but by the fact that Buckleby Grange had mentioned of coming from the Chiltern Hills and Redwick Railway, in some capacity, RTR does exist within the TDRS universe somewhere.
Yeah. Well, it's just they never crossed paths properly.
They don't really cross paths very often. Like,
yeah.
Literally, the only reason that we're displaying Buck at the moment is because within 1975 or something, Buck had another derailment, as usual. But this time it did something to his front end, so he had to come to CS Limited for repairs. So, literally, what we did was just repair him, and Chris was like, oh yeah, do you want to borrow him for a bit and put him in your museum? Because I know you need locos in your museum. Yo, dog, I've now got a museum of locos, so I bought a loco to put in your museum.
Yeah. Someone just asked, what series is RTR? That would be mine, Mr. Leo.
Yeah, Chris does RTR rail to refuse.
Motherfucker.
It's all about engine being put in the bin.
I just dropped a message in case he wants to check it out. I would not blame him if he didn't want to. It's shit.
I wouldn't watch it. I edited it, so definitely don't watch it. I did.
You did the first episode. You did the first episode.
Okay, fine. I edited the first episode.
I did the second one.
Chris did the second one and did a much better job. Anthony's editing the third one, aren't you, Anthony?
The videos.
I need to record episode 3 first.
I need to get writing again. That's my problem. Like, I literally have the idea is what I want to write. Like, I've changed my mind yet again, but I just need to sort of keep going with the idea that I've now got, because I just need to sit and write, and I want to get the first episode written for season 10, because once I've done that, it will unlock the next episodes, if that makes sense. Once I've written it down and know what's going on, I'll know what I'm doing next. It's really annoying when you write. I mean, this is what I keep trying to explain to people. Writing a series is not easy.
I can confirm it's not easy. You'll have days where, like, you'll just sit there, look at it, and just do nothing.
Yeah.
Like, for example, episode 3, I knocked that out in about a day.
Yeah.
Because I just had the inspiration, like, oh, shit, I can do this, this, and this. It changes everything, but I can do that, that, and that, and that would work really well. And then, all of a sudden... It just fell into place. And Seb, go fuck yourself. RTR is not just bootleg TDRS, you asshole.
I mean, no, because, like, you know, if you came in with the storyline you were going for, Chris, I think it would be quite interesting to see the development of the situation you've got going on RTR. It depends on the execution, really, and if you can keep it going.
That's why I always ask for opinions of what I write.
Yeah,
because I don't want to.
It's also why you value my opinion when I tell you that your group doesn't look great and you need to do X, Y, Z, and everyone else goes, "Oh, it looks really good."
Or my personal favorite, when everyone says it looks really good and you say once that it looks bad, and everyone jumps on me saying it's bad.
Suck-ups.
That's pretty much the opposite of what I said just then. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I don't quite know why. Oh, I just heard a whistle. A garth whistle. Go. But yeah, I mean, like, this is why I always get really personally, right? I mean, let me put it this way. Back in the day when, you know, this whole making a series with Railworks thing started, The recent AR Chronicles are the first two people I can remember doing it. And then I kind of joined the bandwagon, and so did Andy, and then a load of other people started sort of like saying, oh yeah, we want to do this too. Now the problem with that, that we've had the years of experience of writing and whatnot, and you know, producing, especially after me for like, you know, 9 whole seasons of the show, it just sort of disheartened me to see other people, like younger people anyway, saying, you know, essentially the same thing, which is, oh, I'm going to write a series, it's going to be about this train on this railway, and it's going to do this, that, and the other. And then, I mean, one of the biggest things I saw was somebody said, I've got a character, but I haven't got a story. Has anybody got any ideas what I can do? And I think to myself, if you haven't got the passion to write an actual story, like for me, my problem is I've got too many ideas. Like, it's not that I haven't got any ideas, I've got too many. And I think my problem with writing, I think I explained to you two, is translating it from the idea to a script. That's the hardest part for me, because I can envision this whole season, I can envision what's going to happen, but actually physically trying to write it down as actual, you know, scripts, it's very difficult. So when I see somebody basically hasn't got any ideas and they just sort of like don't know what they're doing, I just think to myself, like, I mean, as much as I'd like to give them advice, my advice would be, I suppose, think of something. If you've got if you're really passionate about wanting to make something, you have to have, you know, you have to have
a basic outline.
Basic outline, pre-plan it. You know, look at other people, look at what other people have done, and don't copy it, basically. Or if you're going to copy it, at least do what Chris is doing, and you know, well, I say copy.
Make it my own thing.
I'm not saying that, Chris. Like, it came out wrong. What I mean is,
you were
inspired by TDRS, but you originally had a different idea for RTR. It was going to be like, basically, my.
I can explain what it was.
Yeah, go on.
The original idea was something akin to Dead Cod Engines, which Tom had the idea for, which was basically, it was going to start, if you've seen episode 1, you'll know the shed scene. Uh-huh. That was what the original start was going to be. It was going to be Buck crashes, Clark comes to rescue him, and then the whole idea was just like, oh yeah, I've just bought the entire line on all you guys.
Wasn't it going to be basically more bantery, though? I mean, the original idea,
it was going to be batshit insane.
Yeah, it was going to be dumb as fuck. Like, you're going to have, like, you know, engine cartwheeling over the turntable and all that.
Yeah, like, dumb shit. Like, really, really dumb shit. And then,
the problem is, but the problem is, you got really passionate about it.
Yeah.
And then you suddenly came up with an awesome story.
Yeah, because I went from, let's just make some crappy, jokey stuff, like the RTR shorts I make, for example. That would have been the entire RTR, but 14 minutes of it at a time.
Yeah.
And then I went like, well, what if he tries to buy the line, like, doesn't buy the line straight away, but he wants to get the line. And then it went to, but hang on a minute. Why doesn't he try to, how do you say, you know how it works in real life with, like, winning contracts and therefore getting, like, building up the support of the people and then pushing out the company that you build yourself over? I don't know if that makes any sense.
Kind of. I just want to answer a couple of questions I've seen come up in the chat. One of them is, how did I get out the brake van behind Reese's train and behind Chris's train? I didn't realize I'm behind Chris's train, but I managed to wiggle myself out by lighting up a cigarette and burning the rope away. This is, like, people basically saying, about advice, Seb giving advice about writing a story, and I think the most important one he said is, if you need to be invested, creating stories is very time consuming. I can literally relate to that. I think it's just that people sort of maybe need to look at maybe not trying to create a series as such, because I constantly see the same thing. I want to create a series. I want to make a series.
But do you?
I sometimes wonder, yeah, do people want to make a series? It's very, it's difficult. It's not, it's becoming sort of a bit of a niche market anyway. I mean, yeah. I find that, like,
I'm just lucky mine, yeah, shorts are better. I'm just lucky that I actually get some attention to what I do. It's showing that I'm actually going the right direction, you know?
5 minutes later, next episode.
Yeah, true. No, but seriously, here's the thing, guys. With this series, it's not easy, all right? It takes time. It's hard. I have 12 episodes lined out for this first season I'm doing. I have ideas for the finale of season 2 or 3, and I have the ideas for a prequel. Alright? I'm working, planning really far ahead, but I've only written 3 scripts fully and started on a 4th. The ideas aren't hard, it's writing a complete out script with dialogue, an interesting storyline that will captivate the viewers, and narration. And no, don't even get me started on audio and video editing.
Oh my god.
If you don't have a good teacher like Tom, you're fucked.
Now you're fucked.
Yeah. No, you're fucked. I don't know if you guys... I've probably said this a million times, but... I rendered episode 1 fully without the music in Vegas, and then Vegas died on me, where I lost the episode entirely because it corrupted. And Tom basically said, Chris, load a Premiere and I'll teach you. He basically edited it for me, but
I
learned
from
it.
In such a way that Chris could watch what I'm doing, and I gave him advice on, like, okay, if you want to do XYZ, you do XYZ.
Yeah.
But
and
then
as you can see,
I had to sit here and learn Premiere myself, so I know how difficult it is. But once you get the hang of it, it's actually quite rewarding.
Yeah, like, for example, you know the breakaway bar that you had flying across the screen?
Yeah.
You legend. Like, for example, in episode 2, you have the shot where Drax says, wait, what? Where it, like, spins back, as it says, wait, and then spins back into full view again when he says, what?
Yeah.
And that shit, like, I wouldn't have known how to do that if it wasn't for you.
Hmm.
And well, because of that...
Well, in that case, Chris, let's start playing Careless Whisper.
Oh, yeah. Fuck's sake, Tom. And because of that, I was able to teach my friend, aka my sister, how to edit in Premiere, because she's starting to learn that, too.
Did I just hear some Sweet Home Alabama?
Shut your mouth.
Friend and sister. Hmm.
She is like my sister, because we're so similar in every single way, but she's my friend. Tom, you prick. She lives in England anyway, so what the fuck am I gonna do?
Wait, what? Where?
Okay, no.
You're not doing that again. Oh, not again, said Gordon.
She lives in Poole. Wait, what?
No, she doesn't. No way.
No, she doesn't.
What was I gonna say? Oh, I'm gonna do something really naughty, and I'm gonna take Rick on the mainline section up to Brockenhurst.
Uh-oh. I'm gonna turn off my noise suppression again.
Go on then, stop suppressing noise.
Here comes more thunder, hopefully.
I wouldn't bother suppressing it, I like thunder.
Yeah, that's why I turned it off.
Oh.
Come on. I saw the Flash. Not the
CW
one.
You saw Barry Allen?
God damn it. No, I think it stopped. I saw the Flash. Huh, stupid. Oh, that was very weak. Oh, it's rumbling in.
Oh my god, I thought that was going to take me to the headshot then. Oh god, look at that. Ooh. Good job we've got flexible frames, isn't it?
Yeah. Corey Corbett, editing program software, like we said, Premiere, 100%.
Adobe Premiere, yeah.
100% Premiere, because it's just so user friendly. Oh, and Tom, I actually went out and bought the 2020 version.
Oh my god, okay.
Because the whole sound issue just pissed me off, and now that doesn't happen anymore.
Good boy. So we are now going on to, because I've not been talking about the route much, we're now leaving what is essentially the Carson's Railway itself. And heading on to the mainline section, I call it. So, like, you're meant to stop here, and there's a catch point there because you're not meant to go along here. Essentially, for anybody who's familiar with the Swanage Railway, this is a bit like the section beyond Norden going up towards Wareham. That's what it's inspired by. Like, so it's like a section of line that isn't used for regular running, but it's still part of the railway. But because it literally only serves to go to the mainline, it isn't used for regular passenger trains, really. I'm just running I'm just running it for top levels.
True. Also, you know, on the whole topic of series creation, right?
Uh-huh.
To everyone in the chat, there's one thing I want you guys to remember.
Don't eat yellow snow.
I was going to say don't eat brown snow, but close enough. Anyways, seriously,
if you're going to make a series, do not call it the such and such Valley Railway series.
Yeah, never. I mean, Andy's already... That's why Andy rebranded, because he didn't want
to... He felt it was too generic.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Over the Hills...
Is a good example.
Is a good example. The Dark Railway series. Like, you have a railway series, but it's not...
I would say that mine is probably now the most generically named series out there. But,
however...
But I have a brand name on it, if that makes sense.
Exactly.
TDRS.
If you change the name, it will be weird at this point, and you have like a claim to it because it's like you're an original, you know, an OG.
Yeah.
And that's like why I went with Rails to Refuge. Now at the time I didn't know there was a thing that got cancelled called Rails to Salvation. I didn't know about that, honestly. It was Gareth's idea.
5 minutes.
But yeah, no, I find it's more original to have like, and it is kind of, you know, the Rails to Refuge, because it's what it's going to turn out. Oh my god, that's close. Holy shit. Sorry. But yeah, no, it's you'll see as the series progresses what I mean. Especially in episode 3, you'll see what I mean.
Everyone get killed at the end.
Now I'm going to listen for this thunder. Hopefully it's loud. It's about 10 kilometers away, further. It's really far away.
Sorry, we were kind of quiet then, didn't we?
I was hoping for the thunder, but it just never arrived. I hear the rumbling. That's very faint.
The problem with Rick is he'd probably have interesting hammer blow.
Now, I've been meaning to ask this question for a while.
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck is hammer blow?
Okay, hammer blow is you see the wheel go around.
Yeah.
You see them to balance weights.
Yeah.
Basically, hammer blow is the force of the piston pushing on the con rods. And hammer blow is basically the pounding force that the wheels do as they go round.
Okay.
Onto the track, so they're basically banging the track all the time.
Oh, got it.
So that's why, like, engines are balanced. Like, the valve gear has to be balanced with the wheels, and everything has to be balanced out so that it reduces hammer blow.
Copy.
Because, yeah, so basically, you could say that it's all about balancing the weight on the wheels, which is why Rick has a very strange arrangement on his wheels, where his rods aren't his balance weights aren't exactly opposite the actual wheel, because he's got three cylinders. The middle cylinder drives onto the second axle, and the outside cylinder drives onto the third axle. So through scientific testing in universe, we'd say in quotation marks, in order to balance Rick, he has to have his balance weights offset slightly to make up for the opposing force of the inside valve gear. That's just my explanation for that small teeny weeny goof that we came out with. It's not really a goof though now, it's a scientific fact.
Hey Dom.
Hey what?
Imagine a universe where I name my series the Redwick and Chiltern Hills Railway series.
The Redwick and Chiltern Hill Valley Railway series.
Could you imagine?
I could actually.
That would have been horrible.
That would have been funny.
I think just Rails to Refuge just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it?
Yeah, so the Rails to Refuge.
You motherfucker.
You could just put it Rails to the dustbin in that case.
Yeah.
To be fair, like, you know, I like Tales of New Wessex, although it is very similar to Tales of Dexby, but seeing as Dexby hasn't done anything yet, and his railway's not even been built.
Well, if he wants to, I can just put scenery in for him. I'll just, you know, use acid blocks, but fuck him.
Then you got Over the Hills, you had TDRS.
Tales of New West.
Tales of New Wessex, Tales of Refuge. 110th Platoon, I remember.
Yeah. Well, Law has said that's cancelled.
Yeah, but, you know, that was still a decent series in the day.
Mm-hmm.
But now, like, you know, you look at people and they're like, you know, this is the Colwick Valley Railway series, and I have a default 7F called Jim. And he's going to pull a train today, and he's going to make it up the big, steep, nasty incline up to the station that's surrounded by fog and one tree near the platform.
I think I should have made my series on
Valley Railway series, isn't it?
Yeah, I should have made my series on the Chris Central Roundy build for me, which is literally just the stations are fuck you and Chris Smells.
Yeah.
And they're literally 2 feet apart from each other. You see, we're funny. Ted's funny.
I tell you what, this is like the most fun part of the line to climb back up again. That incline there. Because essentially, with the whole token exchange system, this mainline connection, you have to essentially start on the level or on this sort of like slight incline. And you have to try and basically make it so that the back of your train will push you up and over when you're on the way back.
Yeah. Yeah.
I suppose it's pretty obvious now when you look at Rick's wheels about the balance weights, actually. I mean, I'm used to it now. It doesn't bother me.
Yeah. So, about the handrail on the cab, like on the back of the cab.
Yeah, that's not bothering me much either anymore.
Fair enough.
Because there was like the 28, like certain engines didn't have them anyway.
Yeah, true.
So anyway.
Oh, fuck! I fucked up.
Good.
I was setting up for recording, right now, and I realize I removed all the engines because I was doing the stream on the A class. Well, yes.
So the reason we stopped here is we need to await instructions. Apparently. Basically, we've got to wait for the signal to turn green.
I must spun the red signal. Red for anything.
You'll never see me turn green. Oh, why, hold a cow, it turned green. Go.
Did I time that pop perfectly?
Maybe.
Nice. Okay, Anthony has a red baron stuck in my head. Thanks, Anthony.
What about the pink baron?
Right, considering you're the one who got me into that song in the first place.
True. Okay, so apparently this is not the scenario that has stuff on it. Oh, okay. Huh. Interesting.
Oh. Meanwhile, I was talking railway series names, and I'm just here, like...
Someone
can
start having curious about British articulate, though.
Well done interrupting Anthony, you prick.
Sorry!
I can
hardly fucking hear him.
Yeah.
Hello, Thomas.
There you go.
Oh, people are going to go ballistic in chat now. Anyways, Anthony, you were saying?
Yeah,
carry on. All this talk of railways here, and I'm just here like, hi, I did a thing once.
Well, we've already told you what's happening, Anthony. In 2021, ladies and gentlemen, we can officially announce that the Founder 4S is coming to DDJP.
No, you can't.
Come on, Anthony, I'd do a great job.
You can't say that! That's racist!
Thomas, you're racist!
Thomas, you racist bastard!
Oh yeah, everyone's just going, my ears!
Lol.
Who needs ears?
Nobody, that's why I just blew out all your eardrums.
Okay.
Wait, what? Oh, there's a fog descending. Pogo's around. I hear funky music.
Is it Peter Fog?
No.
Oh.
I just hear funky music.
FunkyMusic.com.
The soundboard.
I literally timed that with written whistles. So it was like da 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 da
da. I mean, to be fair, I have the soundboard active. Hello, everyone. Tom would murder.
That worked as well.
I
do love what Chris did to Rick brakes.
What, make them strong as shit?
Yeah. I mean, are you surprised that he's got good brakes? Look at the amount of air tanks he's got on his tender.
True. He's got three massive air tanks, a short stumpy boiler. Wait, hang on, that's not short.
He's got a long stumpy boiler and a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy dome, a short stumpy cab, but he's fucking huge. Engines with proper funnels do. You've only got a small one. Rick looked appalled. My funnel's fine, just as it is. I like my big wide chimney. Makes me steam well. No, what makes you steam well is your LeMaitre exhaust, mate. Your chimney could be any shape. How about a square chimney? No, Rick, you can't have a square chimney.
Why not?
Why not? It would make a nice change.
Oh, it looks like the Bashmash has been here.
You
think about it.
Bastard. Look at him. Blowing off again at the mainline station and all. No consideration for noise at this point.
Well, that's why Rick is a prick.
So my question is, though, do I just run him tender first up to Southampton? Or...
are you going to brave the mainline?
I want to brave the mainline. The only problem is I haven't got anywhere to switch over to... well, I could potentially run to Sway and then move over to the correct line there and have a massive accident somewhere, I imagine. Well, could you go back up the Castleman? What do you lot think?
I would say go up the Castleman just because it is the most scenarized and beautiful part of the route.
Okay, we'll run around and go back to the Castleman then.
I would have loved it if I had said that and you would have gone, right, we're going down to Southampton then, because Chris is wrong. You. You.
Well, I'm going to be doing a speed test on the way back, to be fair.
Oh, are you now?
Uh-huh.
That sounds like my cup of tea.
Does it?
Hello there, I'm Mr. B. I'm Mr. B. I'm a rapist today.
Run away.
For fuck's sake.
That's one of my favorite videos.
Imagine,
wait, why aren't the humans not in?
Can you imagine seeing this fat pillock sat on a level crossing somewhere?
Just blocking the road.
Just like, you know, yeah, everyone just like, what are you doing? And Rick's just like, oh, sorry, was I supposed to move?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you great lummox, you're supposed to bloody move. Get off our level crossing. Get off my fucking platform.
Hey. Someone asks, what is Mr. B's problem? I don't fucking know. I don't write the character.
What is his what?
What's Mr. B's problem? What's I don't Mr. fucking know.
What's Mr. B's problem? He's a fucking prick, that's all.
Oh, thanks. I like Mr. B.
I don't. I'm gonna
must admit, this is the only character you ever allowed me to voice in TDR. No, actually, that's wrong. Contractor.
None of your business, Diesel. None of your business, Diesel.
I'm so glad you didn't do off the cutting room floor with the other.
What, the Scottish one? None of your business, Diesel!
Yeah, I can't do Scottish accents, but I find I love doing them just for the fun of it.
I will point out, in reality, in an normal operating day on the Castleman's Railway, Rick would have come off the train and gone into this hedge shunt here. Another engine would have been sat already up here in this hedge shunt. That would have moved forward, taken the train and taken it back to the Castleman's Railway. And Rick would have run through this platform and into that hedge shunt for water and coal. So basically it would run like a rotor system for mainline operation. If that makes sense to anybody?
Yeah. Maybe?
So like early in the morning, the first train would be top and tailed, basically. Because obviously we're sharing the part of the main line. Same as the signalling system on the busy southwestern main line means that you'd have to sit here for ages waiting for a path back down the main line, basically. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're literally the only people around on Discord at the moment. Oh.
Yep. That's because everyone else are boring pricks, especially that Guion guns.
That Guion kid, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of sad, right, a little bit that, you know, I'm not like, Rick is not going to be available for anybody. But then I realised that, technically speaking, nobody would want him.
Yeah, what's the point of anyone else having him?
Yeah, I mean, he's a vanity engine, for one thing. He is a very big locomotive, yeah, sure, and he looks impressive. But practically speaking, there would be no reason for anybody else to have him.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, he's not getting that much attention as it is to begin with.
He's getting also a lot of attention, but...
Well,
mostly within the fandom.
He'll be getting a lot of attention from the rail enthusiasts when he built. But, I don't know. Like, the idea is that I don't think anybody would really want to, you know, because I did make a joke that I would put Rick up for sale.
£2 million.
Yeah, for like £2 million or something like that. And if someone actually trumped up the money, I'd just say, nah, mate, £3 million.
Mm-hmm. Then they give that, and you'd be like, fuck, that's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money. I could do with that, but no, Rick is my baby.
So anyways, Buckleberry Grinch and BR Lion Black, eh, ladies and gentlemen?
No, shot press.
Oh. But the only problem I have with the BR Lion Black thing that I have for him is the red nameplates, but yeah, I can live with it.
I think I'm probably going to try and do this speedrun pretty quick, because I'm going to try and think about wrapping up for the night, I think.
Fair enough.
So, without further ado, ladies and gents, let's do a speedrun back up the castle railway with Rico. There's just one quick thing I need to double check. I need to double check the point work.
Oh my god.
What?
Oh my god.
What?
Buckleberry and DR Green. Tom, get on it.
No.
Cry. Buck and BR Online Black. Nah, I know. I prefer Line Black to Online Black.
You're racist.
No, okay.
What, you racist?
I mean...
Clark and DR Green, yes, it's happening.
No. That's a path of parcel there. I think what I had already is the path of parcel here. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to go any further than that. So without further ado, let's quickly do this so I can think about going to bed.
No bed for you. Saying do you take all the RTR feet and make it DR Green? No, guys.
Guys, I've got a really important question.
What?
Do you like feet?
Get out.
Cue Oliver making an emoji of that.
Because he gets banned.
So what's it we're doing? We're doing feet test, aren't we?
Yeah. So what's happening to that page show, which was in DR Green once? It's been scrapped.
Oh, what? Herbert Walker?
Yeah.
It's just I'm not sure how, if and how he's going to be introduced at all. Because it's essentially just Dave.
Just fat.
Yeah.
The PH.
PH fat controller, mate.
Fat. Ooh,
so how fast do you think we're going to get before we derail everybody?
5 seconds.
Cool, thanks for the encouragement. Also, place your bets with Anthony, he knows the best. Anthony's got secret mind powers he can see into the future.
Yeah. Anthony, how fast? When's he going to derail? How fast?
It's a Sudoku.
Oh.
I thought you were going to commit to bar.
No, that's Goose. I'm going to become a toaster bath.
Someone asked, will there be a Reba Patriot or a Reba or a Royal Scot? Scott Scotsman does not count. Gonna be a resident on the DR. No.
I don't know yet.
Remember, people, these things are ever changing. Like, one day Tom will say, oh, I love this, I'll have that. Next day, you know what?
I'm like, napkin, yes.
Also, someone said Rick and LNR Apple Green. He essentially is.
I would have done it anyway.
Yeah. Or LNR Blue.
He looked good in Canada. Scott. Blue.
Yeah. Scott Spogarsman does not count because he's not been on the DR, Mr. Thomas Palmer.
Yeah, but he's been in the series, I suppose. Series I don't like LNR engine, but yet we still have Mayflower.
Who?
Exactly.
I say, have you ever heard about that Thomas Dibden fella?
He sounds complete twat, he does.
Fucking Riley is amazing.
I know.
Coming to the scene. Oh, good, so I can do this. Get it away from her!
Someone's already. Well, the people saying Rick liveries. He's already been in most of the points you're mentioning, guys. Like in BR Blue. Tom's already done that.
Me and Edward Bull, who loves to basically hammer on about the fact he did some reskins for me without actually having the logo.
Rip.
I had to do all the hard work, rest in pepperoni. We did Caledonian Railway Blue, BR Green, BR Black, LNER Black, LNER Green, Great Western Green, Great Western Black, Southern Malachi, Southern Olive, which I've kept, Southern Wartime Black, LMS Crimson. There's a whole album of them on the Facebook group, to be honest.
Oh fuck, I misread. He said Dave and BR Blue. I'm a moron.
Mate, I don't want Dave and BR Blue. He'd literally eat me for my dinner.
He'd literally go, done.
So at the moment we've got him up 61 miles an hour, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, well I foresee you're gonna derail before you hit 69.
That's just cheeky, Chris.
Cheeky breeky, vidanka.
No faith in me whatsoever.
Yeah, I think I can agree with James, right? The voice actor from Mayflower is a wanker.
Yeah, I agree.
Didn't you do a DR Blue back in the day, Tom?
Yeah. I did a lot of things back in the day.
Like my ass. Wait, what?
No, Chris. I did not do that bit.
I don't blame you. Sounds like a really shitty job. You hate me, don't you?
Yep. Well, I've reached 69 miles now and haven't derailed yet.
Shit.
Impressive for a freight engine, eh, ladies and gentlemen?
No. You know what's impressive for a freight engine?
What?
Pulling heavy trains. Get it right.
Shut up. Go away.
You're gonna cross over here, aren't you?
No. I've set the points already. Fingers crossed, you should be fine. Yep, we're fine.
You'll never see me turn green. Oh, fuck, I turned green.
Oh no, not again. So what we did is a casual run down to Castleman, down to here, and now we're just like, freaking meow.
No, fucking no. Also, yeah, this is not for kids, you fuckers. Forgot to do that.
Did I just hear a dog?
Oof. I hear a dog.
Yep, it's one of my neighbor dogs. Nothing I can do about it, everyone.
Rest in pepperonis. Why am I so tired? I slept for like 3 hours. Which is probably the most I'm gonna sleep tonight, but ayo.
Ayo.
Way.
way.
Well, you know what they say in America.
Shoot,
this
everyone.
Is America. Oh, we went. Oh, you're going that route. Okay. See how it is. Cracker.
Right, going through Burley. We're definitely going to lose speed here because I've lost boiler pressure.
Yeah.
And,
so what you're saying
Burley
is...
Bank.
What you're saying is you're barely going to make it through here. I thought...
Death.
I'm really happy about that one. I think these were the people I used?
Now you're just some people that I do
use.
The money!
That I used to use.
Oh no, I'm not wearing any underpants.
I'll see you there.
Give me a side camera view, you bastard.
No.
Trackside, please.
Imagine you get it and then you skip through it.
Like that.
Yeah.
Come on.
Press it slower, Tom.
Shouldn't not happen, is it?
Well, it happened a few times if you just press slower.
Screw it, whatever.
It's so annoying that you can't do like shift in that button.
Oh my god, we're doing 76 miles an hour.
Oh, by the way, Tom, did you see that picture I shared of Buck?
No.
Where he had C77 written on a smoke box.
No.
Foreshadowing much?
Oh, right, yeah, I did see that. Yeah, I remember now, sorry.
I love that. Just so close. Rick does look good at speed. Was there even a 77C shed? Yes, there is one.
Yeah, make it.
Yeah.
By the way, we're doing 80 miles an hour.
Nyum. I really wish I could turn the turntable and the sheds and then just weld the track back together, but it's such a pain in the ass.
What's this
open
the footplate at the
foot?
Mate.
Oof.
That would hurt you, Ed.
Oh, you meant like IRL. I don't think there was a 77C. Well, was there a 77C?
No, there wasn't a 77C in real life. Still underrailed, yeah? And we're doing... Yeah, still doing 80.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing about series creations. You gotta always keep a shed that wasn't in real life or else people's gonna point it out. Like, mine's 98. It stopped at 89.
Somebody to find out what shed 69 was.
I got you, fam.
Oh, mate, you know what we've got to do? We've got to research all the engines that were located at 17. Any of the 17?
Shed
17. Could, yeah, they could all be, you know.
Alright, let's see. Luckily for me, Victor Works local number generator has all the shed codes.
Rude.
Alright, so let's see. Oh, that's evil.
What?
It's from what I can see. They stop at 68.
You're joking.
I'm not joking.
Oh, mate, you could do a shed 69.
Tempted. However, this makes sense. You'll never guess where shed 17 is. 17A, that is.
Sodor.
Darby.
Oh.
James Wright.
Okay.
Well, hang on. Darby's in the Midland region.
Yeah.
Then why the fuck is James obsessed with the fucking LNER?
Because he's an idiot.
And on that record, by the way, 69 was on in Scotland. Or 68E, which is the closest to it, was Carlisle Canal. 68D was Beetook.
So shed 69 would be like Lockerbie or some shit.
Something like that, yeah. But no, I'm going through the shed codes list. There is no shed code 69. It goes from 68 to 70.
So far our top speed's been like 80 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Still quite impressive for an engine that built to haul heavy freight trains up at 135.
True. Load that. Yeah. That's why Tom has to shed core 77, Edgar. Oh, for fuck's sake, Reese, you just put flurry in the chat. God damn it, Reese.
Oh, for God's sake, don't flurg me. Don't call me Flurgy.
Because you're not a Flurgle.
I've got an idea that we're probably going to derail here, so I'm going to take the cam thing off so that we can watch the development in all its glory. So, this is the end of the stream, by the way, basically, everyone.
So the conversation has officially derailed.
Yeah, the conversation's literally about to go flying off into the distance. So,
this is why we can't have nice things.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, look at the track now here. Clearly, he's going to derail here at the station.
Oh, he's fucked. He is so fucked.
Literally. Right, wait for it. He's literally going to come around the corner. pause. Yes! Pause, dude.
Oh.
Guys, look at that pause.
Look at the platform, Tom.
Oh, mate, he's leaning on the platform, almost.
No, Tom, look at the guy. He's about to have a really... Is that Mr. Stard?
No, it's not, but this
No,
is...
behind him. Behind the guy in the... That's Mr. Stard. He's going to have a really bad day.
Second from disaster. If anyone wants to meme it, I'm going to put it in the DDJP group.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
That is amazing. So we're going to leave it there, everyone, I think. I'm not going to actually show the crash.
Oh, you absolute cocktease bastard.
I'm not going to show me. I've already shown Rick crashing once or twice. Although I do love that as a screenshot. It's just like, you know what this could be? This could be an advert for the Dark Railway. Dark Railway, what could possibly go wrong?
Anthony, do it.
just Dark Railway, what could go wrong?
For fuck's sake, Tom.
It's brilliant. I love the fact that I've paused it at the exact right time. I'm going to take loads of screenshots before I finish the stream. Should I not be a cock? Right, okay, let's do a vote then. Who wants to watch Rick crash and burn? Nobody's voting.
The one from the my Stard is one from Stard's perspective.
What, Mr. Stard's perspective?
Yeah. Oh, right,
Tom,
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, hang on.
You may be wondering how I got myself into this situation. Well, I was taking the shit at the corner of the station when this thing
actually
pulled in.
No, what it is, it's just like Mr. Stard was just like, I was on the hunt for another engine.
That No, Tom.
Yeah.
I was on the hunt for another engine. Then it hit me. Literally.
Yeah.
Fuck's sake.
Literally, just like Mr. Stars, just like, whoa.
He's like, nope, he's dead.
Yeah, pretty much. He's just like, well, that's the end. Did you get any votes to watch Rick crash, or?
Everyone's saying crash, but take a lot of photos.
Crash's a bitch. Picture takes seconds before disaster. Hannah's an online waifu. Boom, bitch. What the hell? Oh, anime waifu. Killer. Whatever. Anyway. So that's the end of the stream. So let's just watch Rick crash and burn miserably. Ready? Oh. 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 Ah, oh, there we go. What the...
Please is Mr. Start alive?
I don't know. Hold on. Yes, he literally, what?
He's like, nope,
he's like, nope. I'm not, he literally noped away from that. That was great.
He's walking like he shit himself, and I don't blame him.
What's Rick doing, by the way?
Rick is like, ooh, this is fun. He's wiggling.
He's wiggling. Oh my god, he's going into the garden.
Those are my runner beans.
Mr. Stark was not going to purchase this locomotive.
What the fuck?
Little help, please. I can't get up on the tracks.
I appear to have fallen over and can't get back up. Can someone help us?
I can't get up.
Tom.
What?
Ah, oh, fuck, it's Buckleberry all over again.
I'm Buckleberry, sir.
I don't know why I'm finding this so hilarious.
Because it's just fucking hilarious.
It's just a steam engine basically dancing to death.
I feel sorry for the people in, like, coaches, though.
Well, can you imagine just like, you know, this has been a proper accident, and just like, sorry sir, I won't do it again, sir. Damn right you won't do it again, son.
Oh, Mr. Star just standing
ooh
there.
Ooh. Ooh.
The signalman ain't having
ooh
a good day.
Oh, ooh no.
This is Howl and Wiltstone all over again.
Hey, one coach arrived, though.
Yeah. Yes, you could say that. Although the bridge had been wiped out.
Look at the positives. Right. Look at the positives.
Okay, the positives are.
Mr. Starstrip. No, that's actually not a. Oh my god, is that a little Dave?
Well, the driver and fireman have to. Wait, where? It is little Dave. Maybe. Anyway, that's the end of the stream. We crashed Rick on his way back. I hope everyone had fun tonight. And enjoyed the crash of the century. We're going to try and get a second from Disaster poked up in DDJP later. Or tomorrow or something, because I'm going to bed. So, on those last notes, Rick, what have you got to say? Please, somebody get the crane.
Me.